I mean, how did this happen? What went wrong?
Let's see. James Comey, the Russian hacking, emails, being too unlikable, being too likable, being too feminine, being too masculine, the Clinton Foundation, the pantsuits.
Whoa, you made that last one up.
Okay. Maybe I did. I still don't get why you wear those things. You look like a real estate agent. Congrats on getting that big White House off the market.
Hey, I love my pantsuits. They're comfortable and professional. They're like my thing, my uniform.
Women are expected to have better style sense than a uniform. Who are you, Steve Jobs? If you run again, you need to find a stylist with better taste. Speaking of taste, what is this garbage you're listening to?
This is not garbage. This is Les Mis.
Please tell me you're not starting a new career in theater. You've officially gone off the deep end. Come see the critically acclaimed production of Annie starring Hillary Clinton as a tone-deaf 70-year-old orphan.
Okay, first of all, I am not tone-deaf. I am actually a great singer. Second of all, I'm not taking on Broadway. I just like to listen to this kind of music when I'm trying to figure out how to solve a problem. Show tunes are the best soundtrack for tough times. Whenever I need some encouragement, I just think of all of the brilliantly strong women of musical theater and how they would solve these problems.
So instead of responding to Wellesley, you're going to sit here listening to the sad crap?
No. I am going to figure out what went wrong. Broadway style. Yeah. Opportunity to do so much good for this country. As I announced my candidacy in New York City, I talked to the crowd about my biggest inspiration, my mother. She taught me that everyone deserves a chance and a champion. It was time for me to seize my moment and show the nation that I could be their champion. primary and getting the nomination.
It was the best night of my life.
There was still a long road ahead of us, but I was confident that I could defeat Donald Trump. I hit the trail harder than ever.
Future be, I wonder.
their hands, while another 100 people still are making their choice. Are they Hillary fans? And another 100 people found their names on the rolls, and they're using their choice, heading home from the polls, and the rolls in their choice must be me today. These liberal strangers, some who are black, some are gay, these moderate strangers, women who voted for me in May, I'm sure they'll stay. Just one more day, till history is made, and I can say I really lit some sparks, and won this race from that big orange disgrace. No more patriarchs. Choice. I'll make that turtle smile. Not a thing will stand between me and my goals. I'll talk bipartisan reform to save the nation's souls. The predictions have me up over these deplorable trolls. And another 100 people just got home from the polls.
We can now officially project that Donald Trump has won the state of Ohio.
And another 100 people just got home from the polls.
Now has 216 electoral votes. And another 100 people just got home from the
poll. I have confidence. I eventually end up just taking a nap and hoping for the best. It was the worst sleep of my life.
Pantsuits, rise and shine.
Who are you?
You've been putting this audience through almost 20 minutes of your bellowing, and you don't even recognize Ethel Merman. Listen, sweetheart, things aren't looking good for you. This campaign is going down faster than Cole Porter during Fleet Week. They didn't like my voice, and I'd never make it. You know what I said? I said to hell with them and did it anyway. Just like all those characters in those songs you've been trying to sing all night. When strong broads get knocked down, they take their lumps, get back up, and keep going. Whatever happens tonight, you've got to do the same.
Look, I appreciate the advice, but it's not so easy to do that nowadays. You have no idea what I'm up against.
Oh, Christ, here she goes again.
Times have changed, and we've often rewound the clock since the Puritans got a shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, God knows anything goes. Put off your
Straight and unbending, a little
Of a much younger, more idealistic version of myself from my commencement speech back in 1969. I thought the bun and the glasses made me look mature. At the bottom, Tala has printed a quote from that speech all those years ago. The challenge now is to practice politics as the art of making what appears to be impossible possible. It occurs to me that even in spite of my defeat, even after all of the struggling and strife that this nation has been through since November, these words, my words, mean something to her. It's all I need. I march down the corridor and out onto the stage. Over deafening cheers. Chardonnay helped a little too. But here's what helped most of all. Remembering who I am, where I come from, and what I believe.
So whatever your dreams are today, dream even bigger. Wherever you have set your sights, raise them even higher. And above all, keep going. Don't do it because I asked you to. Do it for yourselves. Do it for truth and reason. Do it because the history of Wellesley and this country tells us it's often during the darkest times when you can do the most good. Double down on your passions. Be bold. Try. Fail. Try again and lean on each other. Hold on to your values. Never give up on those dreams. I'm very optimistic about this. Graduate. Congratulations!
And if this was an inspirational film, that would be a great way to end our story. But it's not. This is a musical. In life, one has to face a huge assortment.
Most audacious, my finest.